A meteor shower is a celestial event in which a number of meteors are observed to radiate, or originate, from one point in the night sky called radiant. Meteors come from leftover comet particles and bits from broken asteroids. When comets come around the sun, they leave a dusty trail behind them. Every year Earth passes through these debris trails, which allows the bits to collide with our atmosphere and disintegrate to create fiery and colorful streaks in the sky. Meteors can appear in any part of the sky, so the more of the sky you can see, the better. Find an area with a clear view of the horizon away from trees and buildings. Binoculars and telescopes are not necessary, as they will restrict the size of the sky that will be visible to you. Each shower is best seen remains much the same year after year, while the Perseids are the most popular meteor shower. Perseids are also known for their fireballs. Fireballs are larger explosions of light and color that can persist longer than an average meteor streak. This is due to the fact that fireballs originate from larger particles of cometary material. Fireballs are also brighter, with apparent magnitudes greater than -3. A typical Perseid meteoroid moves at 214,365 kilometers per hour when it hits Earth's atmosphere, and then they are called meteors. Most of the Perseids are tiny, about the size of a sand grain. Almost none of the fragments hit the ground, but if one does, it's called a meteorite. The Perseids are hot stuff, reaching temperatures of more than 1,650 Celsius. As each fragment travels through the atmosphere and both compresses and heats the air in front of it, most of the fragments are visible when they are about 97 kilometers from the ground. The Perseids are the most popular meteor shower, as they peak on warm August nights as seen from the northern hemisphere. The Perseids are active from July 14 to September 1. They reach a strong maximum on August 12 or 13, depending on the year. Normal rates seen from rural locations range from 50 to 75 shower members per hour at maximum. The meteors are called the Perseids because they appear from the general direction of the constellation Perseus, and in more modern times have a radiant bordering on Cassiopeia and Camelopardalis. However, the constellation for which a meteor shower is named only serves to aid viewers in determining which shower they're viewing on a given night. The constellation is not the source of the meteors. The pieces of space debris that interact with our atmosphere to create the Perseids originate from Comet 109P Swift-Tuttle. Swift-Tuttle takes 133 years to orbit the Sun once. It was Giovanni Schiaparelli who realized in 1865 that this comet was the source of the Perseids. Comet Swift-Tuttle was discovered in 1862 by Lewis Swift and Horace Tuttle. Swift-Tuttle is a large comet, its nucleus is 26 kilometers across. Lewis Swift of Marathon, New York, visually discovered it on July 16, 1862, using an 11-centimeter refractor lens telescope. He did not report it immediately, believing that he was observing Comet Schmidt, which was found 2 weeks prior. Then, 3 days later, Horace Tuttle picked it up from Harvard Observatory. Scientists calculated that the comet would return in 120 years. That is, that we would see it again in 1982. In the 1980s, many of us visual comet hunters would, from time to time, cover the part of the sky where the incoming comet was supposed to appear. The 1991 outburst of Perseid meteors indicated that the comet was probably on its way back. Comet Swift-Tuttle last visited the inner solar system in 1992 and will return again in 2125. How to see the Perseid meteor shower? You can look out for the Perseids wherever you are, but there are certain kinds of places that will increase your chances of spotting meteors. Plan ahead and check the weather forecast. If it is likely to be inclement, find a different location or go out on a different day. The days leading up to the peak are usually better than the days after. Reduce the amount of light pollution in your field of view. This could mean heading out to the countryside, a nearby park, or even turning your back to street lamps if you're not able to go anywhere. It is always ideal to try to spot meteors when the moon is below the horizon or when it is in its crescent phase. Otherwise, it acts as natural light pollution and prevents the fainter meteors from being visible. To find the Perseid meteor shower, it's a good idea to look for the point in the sky where they appear to originate from. This is known as the radiant. According to NASA, the Perseids radiant is in the Perseus constellation. Though Perseus isn't the easiest to find, it conveniently follows the brighter and more distinctive constellation Cassiopeia across the night sky. The meteor shower gets its name from the constellation it radiates from. The constellation is not the source of the meteors. To best see the Perseids, go to the darkest possible location and lean back and relax. You don't need any telescopes or binoculars, as the secret is to take in as much sky as possible and allow about 30 minutes for your eyes to adjust to the dark. This does mean that you should avoid looking at your phone. What is the Perseid meteor shower? As comets get close to the sun, they heat up and pieces break off. If the debris ends up in the Earth's path around the sun, it can slam into our atmosphere at speeds of between 7 to 45 miles per second. The actual speed at which a meteor enters our atmosphere depends on the combined speed of the Earth and the debris itself. The average speed for a Perseid meteor is 36 miles per second. The air in front of the meteor is squashed and heated to thousands of degrees Celsius. The smaller meteors vaporize and leave behind a bright trail of light. Larger meteors can explode as fireballs. Though the Perseids occur every year, the stage is already set for a potential Perseid meteor storm in 2028, so mark your calendars now. The Perseids are a prolific meteor shower associated with the comet Swift-Tuttle that are usually visible from mid-July to late August. The meteors are called the Perseids because they appear from the general direction of the constellation Perseus. If you want more advice on how to photograph the Perseid meteor shower, you can ask in comments, but don't miss to watch the Perseid meteor shower.